got a request vest. I'm sorry. A request about a item that I made. It was called the Rubber Band Crossbow by Phyllis Moki. Finally got your name right. And the Annoying Outdoorsman. Alright, the Annoying Outdoorsman asked me, he saw a guy or a person who made a recurve out of a PC pipe. Well, I'm just gonna put it like this is that bow made from the PC pipe. After I show you this part, I'm gonna go ahead and show Phyllis how I made my crossbow. But first, let's take care of the Annoying Outdoorsman. The Annoying Outdoorsman asked me if my jig will work on a PVC pipe bow that he saw was made by somebody. So what I'm going to do is just try to create the bow of a PVC pipe with this real bow here, and hoping that might answer his question. So let's find out, would it work with a normal bow? So let's find out, because I'm curious too. I think it would work if I do it right. If all things fail, you can always make it better. So I guess the Annoying Outdoorsman saw a guy made a bow making PVC pipe. I probably could do the same thing if I put my wits to it, put money in it, which I don't want to do right now. Okay, let's see. Now we need... I'll be right back! Don't move! I'm back! Oh yeah, I forgot to grab the damn arrow. Alright. So... let's see what happens. I don't know if it's going to work like I think. And again, it might have to redo some tying. A couple times of retying stuff to find out where it all goes, where it belongs. Does it belong here? I don't know. Yeah, I do believe after a few errors and tries and errors, I bet you it will work the way I think it will work. Okay. All right, let's retie everything again. Well, I'm untying this and we'll get the arrows. Alright, I'm back. Okay, let's tighten this up more. Like I said, I think it's trial and error about this the slingshot bow. I made a crossbow. How would it work on a bow itself? You see what I'm doing? I hope this is what you're looking for, the Annoying Outdoorsman. I know, but let's find out. This is a judo point. Judo point's good for small game and shooting in the grass. You never lose your arrow when you're shooting the grass. That's what happens. If you don't know where a judo point is, make sure you're in the sun, what a judo point looks like. This is a judo point. All right, the judo point catches the grass with these little hooks here. See these little hooks? And it got a blunt point. So you can kill a squirrel with this. It would tear the hell out of them. Sometimes it goes into this. I kill a couple squirrels with one of these. And it goes into their skin. And it catches them. And they can't go nowheres. Sometimes it kills them. Sometimes it's in Maine. So you have to hurry up and kill it. The poor animal. But that's what you call a judo point. Judo points are good for small games. You can squirrel hunt and rabbit hunt. Now remember, you can make this stronger by tightening the rubber bands, which I did after I figured out, wait a minute, this is wrong. All right, let's find out. Look, it's stuck in the tree. So you tell me the annoying, hey, come down, watch me. The annoying outdoorsman. I hope that answered your question, because look, it's in the tree! That tip was in the tree right there, sir. Let's try it again. You get to watch. You get to watch it go in the tree. Now, see, it's on a long pole, so anything on a long pole should work. As a normal bow, or I hope this answers your question, my friend. Let's try it again. This time you get to watch. Ow, that hurt. All right, let's do it again. Let's have fun. I'm having fun with this. All right, I do recommend you put some gloves on for this. All right, I got some protection on. Pop that in like so. No, it went overboard. Oh. All right, I think this is a good trial and error. Use it a normal, real bow. So if I could put this on a stick, it would still do the same job as my little crossbow. But if you notice, it keeps it stretched all the time. I don't know if that's good or bad. Now, the second request of the recurve or the rubber band bow is, where did I get these rubber bands from? Well, I think you can go to a normal... I remember Ace Hardware used to carry this stuff a long time ago, but I don't know. Well, I'm having so much fun with this rubber band crossbow deal. And a lot of people are asking questions about it. I want to say thank you. A number of questions and just asking normal questions. Look, it was just up there. And I could make this tighter. All right, this is another request from Phillips. I'll let you see this. I'm going to bring it real close. Then I'm going to back it off so you can see really good what that is. Just to remind you, it's something products from my Ohio natural rubber latex tubing. It's 316, 332, 50 feet. This is where I got my rubber band. The second thing I did is bought a normal slingshot, and I took the thing off, and it looks like it's missing. and I put one of these on there just to keep it, make sure it don't pop off. But it looks like it was still there. It didn't pop off. So I'm safe there. I got a little tear there. Because I was working too hard with it. And the second question, Phyllis wants me to make my bow from scratch. This is the things I had to use to make that recurve. First I added this, the second video you ready to watch before this video. I have a belt, I have this rope. This was given to from me from Grumpy, the Grumpy. Thank you, Grumpy. And I have this cord. So what you need is a pair of good working gloves. And a good saw. A belt, 550 cord, and another piece of 550 cord. So what I'm gonna do is go hunting for a piece of wood. I think I got some somewhere. Alright. I wanna try something different, Phyllis. But I wanna still do it the way that I originally built it. So I got a new piece of wood. I'm gonna try to use that fork. All right, instead of making a two piece, I'm gonna make it one piece. You wanna go find a fork. This is a test. A test for the Phyllis. Mephilili, whatever I can pronounce the last name. All right, let's see if I can get this gearing. All right, remember, the closer you tie it up, the more powerful you'll be. I can put it this far and still have enough power to, more power to do more damage. The farther I bring it back, the less damage. Then again, is how far I pull it back. So if you notice, this is a small stick, so we gotta, you know, work with that. But a normal slingshot, I think, gives you about that much span, like a handful. So if I tie this close enough, like a normal slingshot, but I have no extra cordage, so I gotta really tie that baby on there to make it work. So I'm doing a test for a Phyllis to see what happens. All right, bam. I'm making it as short as I can to symbolize, listen to me. Make it look like the same thing as a normal slingshot cordage that you usually get on a slingshot. And see what happens. Now I don't have to make that T like the original crossbow had. I just put it on here. This gave me a creative idea when Phyllis asked. So thank you, Phyllis, for the cool idea. Making it the normal way I had it, I'm gonna make it this way. So you say, hey, I can get the same material that Ranger Kooky got, because I have woods. That's basically what I'm trying to show you. You can use any type of material to do the job. All right, let's go down. And if you want me to make the crossbow version, just to show you how I made it, I'll make it. It's simple, it's only two pieces. I can show you the original and show you what I did. Let's tell you what I did. But this is showing you that you can go out and get almost any material, like the bow, a PVC pipe. All right, there you go, we have. Now, I made it smaller to symbolize this normal slingshot you buy And I'm going to use the judo point again. Let's go to our test shot area.
Alright, you get to watch me from the beginning to the end. My camera's working right this time.
Basically, you want to see what I'm doing? I put it on my thing. Lock and load my arrow. Hey, this looks like it's better. Pull back, it's going to sling like a bitch.
Damn!
Like I said, the shorter I got it, the more powerful it's going to be. And it was kind of hard to pull back. Alright. Oh, shit. It finally broke. You remember I was telling you that little cut? It finally broke. Alright, now it's going to be a bitch to put back together. Damn you, boy! Bossy, because he's gonna. Alright, I'm back with the fun! So far, this is my third video on the rubber band slingshot crossbow diggity dang. Alright, let's try it again and see what happens. There we go. I could probably kill a deer with this one. It's really stronger. It's closer, and I got a lot of power going off that arrow. So let's try again. I'm using a judo point. It's good for small game, and you won't lose it. You won't lose your arrow in the grass like most arrows. When you use a judo point, you barely lose it in the grass. It popped off because I didn't put it on there all the way, but. It didn't pop, it just came off. Alright, well, have you seen the results, Phyllis? I hope that answered your question. But I want to show you my original bow real quick. Alright, here's my original crossbow that you asked about. The only thing I did was make two pieces. I took the first piece and I just cut a slot here and another slot there for the arrow, but it didn't work like I wanted to. Then I made some type of trigger device and I made a flat surface. Then I took the rope and the materials. I took the belt. The belt helps me keep it there so I can tie it down better. And that's what I did. But I just made a simple, quicker version because you wanted to see different. I think it's what you wanted to see, different results. So that gave you the different results. So basically, it's just two pieces of wood bound together with 550 cord, a flat edge with a trigger device that didn't work. I mean, it could work if I worked on it, but I didn't work on it. It's too long. So that's it. And you saw the second one, I just used a fork piece of wood, and I had to work on the little bandage things, I had to put them back on there, but hey, it worked. Alright, I'll read you cookie. I hope this answers your question, Phyllis, and the annoying outdoorsman. Alright, if you have any other questions, don't forget you can ask me. I will answer in a video response if needed. This one needed. I usually try to answer all my questions with a video response. If you have any other questions or comments or want to watch a certain type of video, let me know below. It's free to do. All right, I'll read you cookie. I'll see you next video.